Hi everyone, I'm Kenneth Wong. I was born and raised in Burma. Now I live in San Francisco, California. So obviously I speak Burmese. I actually also teach Burmese at UC Berkeley. And since I'm a big anime fan, I'm also learning to speak Japanese. Glad to be on this program.
My name is Htet. I was born and raised in Burma, like Kenneth. I lived there until 14. So I speak Burmese. And I am currently living in the US.
Hi guys, glad to be here. My name is Anshul and I currently live in Bengaluru, that is the southern part of India, and I'm pursuing a doctorate in Bangalore, and I'm basically from northwestern part of India, and I've been raised in many different states of India, and that's why I can speak like five languages. English is one of them, obviously. Yeah, glad to be here.
So hi guys, this is Soham. I am originally from New Delhi, India, and I spent 22 years of my life there, and for the last 3 years I've been living in the United States.
Thank you so much, everyone. So now we're gonna get started, and Kenneth, you're gonna read the first word in Burmese, and the Hindi speaking side will see if they can figure it out, or if they might need any hints, then you can give them hints. So you can go ahead and read it.
All right, to Hindi speakers, here we go. The first Burmese word is gobi. Gobi.
Can I take a guess?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
So it sounds like gobi to me, which means cauliflower. Is
exactly
that what you're getting?
Slightly different pronunciation, but we call cauliflower gobi.
And with some of the words, they're going to be very close, almost identical. But with some of them, the way it's pronounced is slightly different. So you may have to think a little bit, or if you want a hint, then you can ask for one. So sure. Now we're going to do the first Hindi word.
My first word is alu.
Yeah. Alu is smiling. I think you know what it is.
Yeah, alu. We also call it alu, potato.
Yeah, that's correct.
Really interesting. Yeah, I've actually seen when I go to Indian restaurants here, aloo gobi is a dish that I see on the menu.
Aloo gobi is one of my favorite dishes. Yeah.
Pretty common dish. My word is batama.
Can you repeat the word again, please?
Yeah, it's batama.
Batama. Yeah.
I think the pronunciation in Hindi might be slightly different for this word.
Yeah, it has to be, because what I'm thinking, it can't be that.
Is there like a vowel that's supposed to be deleted somewhere?
That's true. When Burmese adopted foreign languages, they tend to add a final vowel that it's not there in the original language. So take that into consideration, indeed.
Okay.
That's true. Yeah. Yeah.
So something like patam, maybe like if we delete the final A.
But there's an N also in between, I guess, right?
There's an N in between?
I heard N.
No.
Oh, it's patam. Patam. Does it mean to like read or learn? Prathama first?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
that's
okay.
It.
Okay. Oh, Pratham.
Oh, okay. Pratham, yeah. Pratham is
Pratham.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So we add the A behind.
But there's
and then R is deleted in between.
But there, yeah, but there's th and you have th. There's a difference, right?
Yeah, and there's no R in between. I think that was the most tricky part.
Yeah. So keep in mind, like as I was saying before, the words are not going to be identical.
Identical, yeah.
So you have to sometimes think about it. Like it might be a little challenging, but you know, you'll be able to figure it out. And if you need a hint, just ask for a hint.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
The next Hindi word is kriya.
That would be a word that comes up in my language class, because when we dissect sentences, we would identify the verb as kriya. Kriya.
Yes, that's exactly correct.
Could you pronounce the Hindi version again for me?
It's kriya.
It's almost identical, actually.
Yeah.
How do you pronounce it?
Kriya.
Sorry?
Kriya.
Kriya. Kriya. Okay.
Yeah.
The R is a little like what do you say? Prominent in Hindi.
Yes, right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The next word is Jong. Jong.
Jong.
Jong.
Does it end with an M?
Yep.
You might hear an M, but Burmese words don't have ending consonants, so we would just say is Jong.
Okay. Jong. And is it more like a ch in the beginning or a j in the beginning?
J.
J. Jong. Jong.
Think of some food related again.
Okay.
Jom. Jom.
It's something that is, you know, what you make with it is very much popular in, I guess,
in both countries. In both countries, that's right.
So, is it something like wheat?
That's it.
Oh,
yes.
Okay. Because the word that we use for wheat is like gehun, which seems quite far from what you said.
So, no, but I think the Sanskrit word would be similar to, I think. Because you commonly use it like we say, just say gehun or gehun. Kanak. Or gehun. Kanak.
That one was a bit far.
Yes. As I said, some of them are a little bit different. And like not different, but just the way that they're being pronounced. You know, the way that through the course of history it has changed a little bit, right? So it becomes a little challenging. I want to mention something about the next word. I guess in Hindi you could use this in multiple different ways, but it doesn't matter because I guess the Burmese side is going to hear it and you just say what it means to you. So when Anshul you're ready, you can read the next word.
Sure. So the next word is samudra. Samudra.
Samudra. Oh, Kenneth, I think this is similar.
What do you think,
it sounds
Kenneth?
Like the motia to me. Is this the word for ocean?
The motia. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's amazing because it's almost all the S sounds in the original Sanskrit are Pali. And when it gets to Burmese, it becomes the S, the TH sound.
The T.
So we would pronounce the word for ocean as Thamodia. Thamodia.
Oh, okay. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a really good guess.
I wouldn't have been able to do it.
Yeah, I did grow up studying a little bit of Sanskrit where there were a lot of the S words. We like in Burmese, they actually changed to the TH sound. So I was, kind of sometimes when I try to, I guess that like unconsciously try to guess those, like convert those sounds.
So Tat, you're going to read the next one. And this one I found very surprising.
My next one is Namuna.
Namuna. Example?
Yeah, that's exactly the same.
Or a sample or an example.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's correct.
Yeah. Giving an example, you know, we also use another word which I think also is, it came from Pali. It's called ubama. We also say ubama to say example, but namuna is example as well.
Namuna,
and like in Hindi, it's also used like colloquially, like you know, when to make fun of someone, or if someone is a very particular character, you can say that this person is a namuna. I know that happens in Burmese a lot. But in Hindi, it happens.
So the next word is pesa. Pesa.
Pesa. Pesa. Pesa sounds like the Burmese word for money, which is pasa.
Yep, exactly. Exactly.
Oh, wow. We sometimes call it paisa. We sometimes call it pasam. Both pronunciations are acceptable, but that it means money.
Kenneth, we're back to you again with the next one. So you could go ahead and read it.
Yes. My next word is Yupa. Yupa.
Is it like youth?
Say that again.
Youth?
I think young people certainly have that advantage, yes, but it's not exactly that.
Okay. So yupa, you said?
Yupa.
Something like form or something, form or appearance.
That's it.
Yep.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah. We would pronounce it yupa. It means if somebody have good appearance, decent look, that will be referred to as yupa yogi or yupa.
Okay.
So the next word is vidya.
Can you repeat that?
Vidya. Vidya.
Vidya.
Vidya.
Vidya. Vidya.
Kenneth, I know the V sounds kind of gets converted to the W sound.
It usually become wa, so it'll be, we are looking at words like Wideha.
Vidya,
Vedana. Does it have any religious connotation, this word?
Not necessarily. It's a very day-to-day used word.
Any hints for us?
So if you read a lot, you will gain something.
So the hint was good. I just want to mention one thing. The way that this is being used in Burmese nowadays, I think, is a little bit different. Although both words share the same root.
Same root. Oh, okay.
Yes.
So it seems like the Burmese word has something that's less to do with the real world and more to do with like someone who deals with something that goes on not in the real world or doesn't appear to be real.
Yes.
Say the word again, please. Let's hear it again.
So the word is vidya.
Vidya. Vidya.
Yeah.
Is it like waisa? I don't know.
Oh, waisa.
Is that what's the
waisa is a wizard?
What's the meaning? A wizard?
Yes.
Yeah. I think that's the word.
Really? Oh, that's interesting because
we don't use it like that.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Hindi could be more like knowledge.
Oh.
Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, because the root word is knowledge, but when it gets to Burmese, we use it as somebody who has mastered something to a high degree. So we call it waisa. Yeah. Wigsa,
okay.
An alchemist, a magician, somebody who has supernatural sight and ability would be Wigsa. Yeah.
So interestingly, the way you're pronouncing it sounds very close to the English word wizard.
That's true. In fact,
there's some connection there.
Yeah, there may be some connection there because in Burmese, Wigsa is wizard.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Broader. In Hindi schools, like the school would mean Vidyalay, like a learning place. Vidyalay.
In Burmese, when you separate science subjects from art subject, humanities, the humanities and art subjects are actually referred to as Wigsa subjects.
Oh, okay.
Knowledge related subjects.
My word is Mirana.
Sorry?
It's Mirana.
To die. Because marna, in like the infinitive form in Hindi would be marna. To die is marna.
Yeah.
It's amazing because in Burmese we tend to use it the noun form to mean death.
Mm-hmm.
The word marna. The noun would be death.
Oh, the noun would be mrityu. Mrityu.
Mrityu.
But the infinitive form would be Marna.
Marna. Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. So now let's finish off with the final word, and then we'll move to the senses.
Yeah, the word is Yantra. Yantra.
Yantra. Yantra.
Oh, is it Yantaya, like a machine?
Like, yeah.
Yantaya.
That's right. Absolutely.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Oh, that's yeah. Yantaya. Yantaya is a Burmese word for machine, machinery. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. The words were really good. That was awesome. Thanks a lot, guys. Yeah. And now we're going to move on to the sentences. For the sentences, there's one word in common. Like, there's one going to be one word in there that you'll probably just pick up right away or you hear right away. So Kenneth, we're going to start with you. So you can go ahead and read your sentence and see what they can figure out from it. You can go ahead.
I'm going to ask a very simple yes-no question with this word. Gita chaila. Gita chaila.
Gita?
Yeah, I heard Gita. So that's like the holy book of Hindus.
It's you might be thinking about Bhagavad Gita, but it's not as sacred as that. It's more common. Gita chaila.
Is it like a song?
Yes.
Sing
a song.
What I'm asking you is, do you like music? Chaila is the Burmese word like in a question form. So Gita, the Burmese word, is actually music in general.
I see.
So usually we just Geet, yeah.
Yeah, we usually refer to music as Sangeet, and Geet is like a song. Yeah.
So the sentence is Prithvi ek grah hai. I would like slowly say it now. Like, there's just four words. Prithvi ek grah hai.
Prithvi ek grah hai.
Yeah, absolutely. That's correct. Yeah.
Oh. The pronunciation. In what kind of circumstances would you make a comment like that or say something like that? Could you give us some?
When I'm studying when I'm studying the solar system.
The Burmese word for planet is Jo. Is it? Is Graha the word for planet or star system?
Yeah, Graha is planet.
Oh, that's interesting. Somehow, the pronunciation is very far from the Hindi pronunciation. We call it Jo. But I recognize in the way we write it, that the original R and everything is morphed into our diacritic words that turns it into the word Jo.
Right, now that you mention it, we also have the H, kind of have the H consonant, we just don't pronounce it.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. H maybe becomes silent. When we spell it, when we spell it in Burmese script, we still see the H consonant in there. We just don't pronounce it. So that's why I was able to figure out it might be the word Jo.
So when you guys write Burmese, are there a lot of silent consonants?
In many words that are derived from Pali. Yes, there are a lot of words that we can see, but they're not part of the pronunciation.
I see.
Yeah.
But they are the part of the pronunciation in like Indian subcontinent, basically. So maybe that is the reason.
Yeah. But what was the exact meaning of what you just said? Yeah.
Earth is a planet.
Earth is a planet. Okay.
So Prithvi is Earth, like the planet Prithvi. So literally like Earth. Our planet is literally.
The planet is. That's right. That's right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My sentence is Baden Zi Samala.
Sorry? Can you repeat that again?
Yeah. My sentence is Baden Zi Samala.
Baden Zi Samala. Samala.
Are there two separate words, Samala, or are they? How many words are you using in the sentence?
So, Badan, see, it's a noun, and then Samala, it's a what do you call it, adverb?
Namana is a verb in the question form.
A question form, yes.
Yeah. I see. And but you're just using two words, right?
That's right.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so is the first word something like cloud?
No.
No?
Okay. You said Badanzi, right? Badanzi.
Yeah.
Badanzi. Badanzi.
This is a compound word, so it's mm-hmm. it's two things that comes together that refers to a particular section of the whole thing.
But then, does it mean body or some? Is it related to the human body or something?
No.
But then, no. But then,
yeah.
Afterwards, bad me baden.
So we are focusing on the correct word, right? Like the word that's more related to Hindi is the first one or the second one?
The first one, yeah. And then we have different different forms of the thing. We call it Badansi, Badanti. It's like a different.
Yes.
Yeah.
Is it an almond? Nut? No?
That's yes. it.
Oh.
That's it. Badam.
That's it. Badam. Yeah. Badam.
Badam. Mm.
Yeah.
But
so to refer to the
Go ahead, Ted, please.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but this is what I know. So to refer to the almond seed itself, we call it Badan seed, which like seed is basically seed.
That's right.
So yes. The seed inside. And then Badan the is like the bottom fruit, the almond fruit itself.
So it's like Badam seed. Do you like almonds, something like that?
Do you want to eat almond?
Want to eat almond seed? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That word is interesting because in Burmese we pronounce it both bada and also banda. Some people pronounce it banda, some people pronounce it bada, even though it's the exact same plant, exact the same thing.
Yeah. Both of you guys used just two words in the sentence and both of them had the pronoun you, like they had the second person pronoun, but it was it omitted? So you guys don't use the pronoun? Is it like hidden?
When we are speaking to somebody directly, we often leave it out because it's pretty clear that we're asking that question to that person. If we are talking about a third person, then that pronoun is important. So I don't know if that's the same rule with Hindi.
Yeah, actually, now that you say,
Badam khaoge, like, would you like to eat badam?
Yeah.
Badam khaoge.
Yeah, so the pronoun you in Burmese would be kamya. For me, being a male person, or for Tet would be shin, being a female speaker. Did not appear in our sentences at all because we feel like we're speaking directly to you. We don't need to use it.
Yeah.
So in Hindi, the verb would change according to the gender and the number. So even if, if you're speaking to someone directly.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, so now we're going to do the final sentence. So Soham, you can go ahead and read it.
Yeah. So the final sentence is Hanuman Hamare Dev Hain.
Well, I recognize the word Hanuman because I grew up watching the Ramayan epic in Burmese dance theater.
So you get a hint from there. So there's another word that I'm trying to help you out with, like Hanuman Hamare Dev Hain. Do you recognize another word there?
Hanuman Hamare Dev Hain.
Yeah.
Devi
would be queen or princess. Devi could also be goddess.
Yes. So,
Devi
so Devi is a goddess, but Dev is like there's some just a very little difference. Yeah. It's a god.
Dev is god. Yeah. Devi is goddess. Dev is god.
So. Hanuman is the god.
Yes, Hanuman is our god. So Hamare means our.
That's right. I mean, is that the sentence you're saying? Hanuman is the god.
The sentence is Hanuman is our god.
Hanuman is our god. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
How would you in Burmese normally, like if you were to just say God or Lord, how would you say it?
In the Buddhist sense, it'll be Paya, but that actually means the enlightened being. But in a more broader sense, to refer to any kind of supernatural being and spiritual lord, that'll be Dewa or Nat. Mm-hmm. Nat, minor deities, or Dewa, the more broader word.
Deva is basically Dev, I think.
Dev, yeah. That's true, because that's Deva true. Become Wa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We also use Deva. Yeah. We also use Deva.
Oh, we also Deva. Use Deva.
Mm-hmm. Both we use, yeah. It depends.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. In fact, when the Buddhist monks say in their prayers, may this good deeds be spread out to all the human beings and all the spiritual beings around the world, they would usually say Nat Dewa, to refer to mm-hmm. both types of deities and spiritual beings.
Oh, that's interesting.
Interesting. Yeah. Interesting. Well, that was we're done now with the sentences. I think I don't know about you guys, but for me this was very interesting because these are two languages that share like a historical connection. Like, so it's always very cool when you break down like these sort of similarities.
Thanks, Bahadur, for having us here.
Thank you, Bahadur.
You bring people together. That is what we need today, right?
Yeah, exactly. Thank you. Thank you very much for hosting us. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We know in the colonial time, right, there was a lot of immigration that go back and forth between our two countries. But and I think the similarities in the languages reflect that the relationship actually is, it predates to colonial time. It's much earlier, all the way to the days of kings and queens a long time ago. Yeah.
So the Burma has been mentioned in many ancient Hindu texts also, many Buddhist texts also. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it dates back way, way, way long back, you know. It's just true. Not the
yeah. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be part of it. Looking forward to other episodes as well.
Thank you. Thank you guys for being a part of it. My pleasure. Thanks a lot for being a part of it. As I said, I enjoyed it a lot as well. Like throughout the process of like putting it together, I learned a lot, and it's always very like it's very enlightening, you know, when you look at the word and read the history of it. And it was very, very much a fun video to put together. So thank you so much. Take care, and we'll talk soon.
Have a great day, everybody. And bye, get some sleep. Get some sleep from India.
Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye.